My name is Molly Bergman. I'm an SSA supervisor with Montgomery County Board of Developmental Disabilities, and I've been working with the 811 program for almost a year.
And I'm Nicole Bowers, and I'm an SSA supervisor also with the Montgomery County Board of Developmental Disability Services, and I have been working with 811 for almost a year as well.
So in order to become a referral agent for 811, you need to do the training. It's all online through a webinar, and then you register through SocialServe, which is the online application server that's used in order to get everybody on the wait list. And that's pretty much it. It's a very easy, simple process, very self-explanatory. And then you're good to go. I think 811 fills a gap within the community. A lot of our shelters are full. Section 8 is not currently taking new applications. People don't want to live in the traditional group home setting, yet they can't afford market rate housing. So I think 811 is a good option for them. It's income based. It's still a nice apartment that they can live in and be successful on their own out in the community.
So the difference between 811 and what we have been exposed to previously is this was specifically designed to integrate people with disabilities into the community, and it had designated spots where typically we're used to trying to make it work, and there's very limited resources that you're on waiting lists for so long. These are already accessible and ready to go for the people who need them.
A lot of our folks don't identify with their disability or don't see themselves as a person with a disability. So being out in the community just helps kind of support that feeling that they have, so they can be in the community and ride the regular transportation systems or go to the grocery store and do what they need to do kind of on their own without having staff with them, which sometimes makes them feel different than other people. This way they feel just like everybody else in the community. I think it means just being on their own, doing things like you or I would, being independent in their day-to-day activities. You know, someone's not telling them when to take a shower or when to go to the grocery store. They can do that when they want, just like anybody else. One of the main things we look for is they need to meet the income requirements, but beyond that is, are they able to live in the community? Do they have the skills to be alone in the community, or do they have the supports and benefits in place already, so when they go into the community, they're going to be set up for success? You know, where are the 811 apartments? Are they in a part of town that they want to live in? What does the building look like? Is it an accessible unit if they would need accessible? Will it meet their needs on a day-to-day basis?
And I agree, when we're looking at, does somebody meet the standards? Are they able? We can build services around them to make any situation successful, but they have to have the desire and they want to succeed in the community. If you have that cooperation in the right setting, it'll be great.
I think the biggest piece of advice we could give is to make sure you know the 811 program and know the requirements and the documentation that's going to be needed. It can be overwhelming. It's pretty easy to work through once you know the different policies and procedures with 811, and then just knowing your individuals and knowing if they would be appropriate for the program.
I think it's just a matter of knowing everything takes time and that it's going to be amazing at the end, so be patient and don't accept no for an answer. It'll work its way out.
One of the big issues we had is a couple people being denied from the property that they were trying to rent, and we did not take no for an answer. We filed a couple reasonable accommodations as well as reasonable modifications and worked with the leasing agents to get those issues resolved, and ultimately it resulted in them moving in and being in their own apartment. There's honestly nothing more exciting when someone moves into their own apartment for the very first time. Their eyes light up, they are so happy, they are so proud of what they have accomplished. They got to buy their own furniture, they got to pick out what they hang on the walls or what their decorations are, and that doesn't happen too terribly much in their lives. If they've lived in a group home, a lot of times that's already been picked for them, especially if they moved in when there was already three other people there. Sometimes that kind of stuff is already established. When they get their own apartment and they move in for the first time, they get to pick all of that. And to watch someone have that experience is extremely exciting.
I had a gentleman, he'd been living in a supported living home in the community with a group of gentlemen, and he was not happy. He wanted his own apartment, but housing is a challenge. Rent in the community is very expensive, and he couldn't afford to live by himself, and then 811 came along and we got him through the process. And even though he needs supports, 811 and the building itself has worked with us, and he's got remote monitoring. He's in his own place. He has drop-in services as well, and he is doing wonderful. He is so happy, and he feels like he's living on his own in the best place that he could be.